Okay, so now we move into the topic of design patterns. So design pattern is a well-known technique for ROB development of a software system. But it's not easy to use it. It's not difficult to understand it, but it's not easy to use it. Okay, so design pattern, that is something you do it again and again for the similar situation, it become a pattern. And the pattern design, that means there are many situations in many different software, in many different domain, but the situation is the same. So you will design it at the similar thing. In that case, you have the design pattern. So there's design pattern, this term come together with the concept of OOP because most of design pattern use object-oriented paradigm. Especially, you only understand design pattern once you fully understand the concept of inheritance and polymorphism of object-oriented programming. But the idea of how to organize, how to design your software clean, easy to maintain, easy to develop, still useful, even though you don't use object-oriented programming. That means the concept of coherence and cohesion that I will show you later in the live stream session. Okay, so there are many design buttons. Later you will know. But there are some famous button that I will introduce to you. You have a concept of observer button. Observer button use when you have multiple view of a state of an object. The state, what does it mean? State is the internal value of an object. In the most popular case, you have for example, database. So the database, you have multiple view of it. You have the bar chart view or the column view. Okay, so the thing is, when the database change its value, what does it mean? It means that the database change its state, its internal state. So the view must be changed accordingly. When the value of A and B, for example, change the area of A and B, or the height of A and B must change. So how could we people do in that case? So if you apply the pattern of observer, you will have many observer upset, observe this one, surprise this one. So the model, when the database or the model change, it will notify all of the observer, and the observer will update its value. So that is the class diagram. So I think that this class diagram is useful enough for you. Okay, it's useful enough for you. Then you will have this one, the database, but this is abstract one. It can be anything. It can be a database. It can be a record, a object that have multiple state, and it can be, it can have many observer. Okay, so when this subject change, it will notify the observer. The observer will update itself. So this is the abstract layer. And when you apply in your software program, you will inherit the abstract layer by the real class. Okay, the real class, for example here, the view, the bar chart view and the column view will be the implementation of the abstract class. Okay, so we will have some practice on the class, so you will know in more details about the way of using observer button in some situation. So most of the useful, the most popular uses of observer button is the MVC. MVC, model controller view architecture. In that case, the model will be this one, okay, and the view will be that one, okay. So the controller change the subject that in the model will notify the view, okay, to change. Some of other popular one is, apart from observer, you have fast save button. That means you have the component that have multiple classes interacting to each other, but this component has only one interface classes for the outside interact. That's the fast save. One of the most useful popular application of fast save button is the compiler. Inside the compiler, there are many internal classes. You will know it later when you study the course of principal programming language. But when you use the compiler, you just, for example, how can you run your C++ program? You only type run, okay, or you press the button run in your IDE. Okay, so in that case, this is the fast save. After this class is activated, there are many internal interaction between the internal classes of the compiler. You never know, and you don't need to know unless you want to study insightfully about the compiler. Okay, so that's the fast save button. The iterator button is the perhaps the most popular and the easiest button to understand. That means you enter, you make a loop, you travel all of the element in the collection, and you do some action on that. In contrast, the decorator button is very nice and not easy to understand about this class. You want to change the functionality of a class, but not the change is not happen during the design time, during the compile time, but it will change the functionality during the execution time. Okay, so the function app will do another action. The method, a method of a class will do another action in response to some event. Okay, even though you never decide it before. Okay. So this is the decorator button. This is very useful, but one of the most hardest, one of the hardest button to understand. So as I told you, we will study about some button carefully in the class later. Okay, so when you implement a software in the bus, you will build it from the class, but now it's not easy. It's very hard to see a software built from the stress. But basically, it will based on some existing component or existing library. Okay, so this concept of reuse in implementation. Reuse means reuse some objects. For example, reuse of the button, design button, or you reuse some class, some offset already developed, or you reuse a package component, and sometimes you can reuse the whole system. Okay, so and implementation, you will choose your platform to develop your IDE. For example, in C++, when you study at the first year, you may use some simple IDE, but later on when you working outside, you will use some complicated IDE. Okay, so and you can also use some open source. Open source also reuse the code, but now this is the rule. People provide shortcode to you, not only the package, the bytecode component, but they provide you the shortcode. Then you can use the shortcodes in your program. So open source doesn't doesn't mean free software. Open source still commercialized software. But this is the rule. This is the code of open source. That is, when you use open source, you must follow the rule. Then your product, even though you sell it, you must sell it with the short code. You cannot hide your short code. This is the rule. Okay. I also work for some company that use open source component to develop their product. And when they sell the product, they must sell together with the code. You cannot hide your code. Okay. One of the best known open source may be the Linux operating system, and there are many other open source library here and there for you to use. Okay. There are some license model for open source that I told you. Okay, when you use the short release under a license model, you must follow this license. Okay, so I think this is the end for this design button and implementation. You will have, as I told you, we will get back later in more detail about design button when we work together in the class. In the meantime, entertain yourself with some quiz first. Okay, see you.